The question before us is, does the weapons type command actually work? To properly examine this question, we will look at the last version in which the command actually worked for Harpoon. This is Harpoon version 3.6, also known as Harpoon 3. We'll load a demonstration scenario named weapons tight. In this scenario, we are in command of an Ticonderoga class Aegis cruiser, the Anzio. In the north, the enemy will be firing missiles towards the bunker complex as well as towards the Anzio. It should be noted that weapons tight command only applies to anti-air defenses, and it only applies to human controlled units. This means that any side under AI control and any unit under an AI mission, which is one of these missions that might be created, is always under weapons free. Only the unassigned and plotted missions are the manual missions, whereby human control is exerted. Once again, repeat, weapons type only applies to human controlled missions, that's plotted and unassigned. Any AI side is always under weapons free. Secondly, AI weapons tight only applies to anti-air defenses. Even though ships may appear, the weapons free will not engage land units, surface units, submarine units, only air defense. Third and lastly, weapons tight is only for area defense. Certain weapons, such as the Mark 15 Phalanx guns, these are close-in weapon systems, are designated point defense weapons. This means that they will fire in defense of the ship if the ship is under attack. Regardless of human intervention, they always fire. Other things that are point defense weapons are chaff and flares, and decoys are point defense weapons, and they will operate regardless. Actually, they'll operate better. The human intervention is not required. They will not fire for a human player and will fire on their own. Some missiles can also be set for point defense. For example, the evolved Sea Sparrow missiles are point defense weapons. However, the standard missiles, surface-to-air missiles, are not point defense weapons and will not fire unless in weapons-free mode. We'll demonstrate this. We'll start the scenario, and we can see here is a friendly ship. This is simply a missile picket, a radar picket ship. All she's doing is has her radar active and is detecting the enemy vessels and their inbound missiles. The Anzio is on unassigned and it is currently passive. We'll make sure that our weapons are tight. Notice this single missile is approaching and it will attack the Anzio. Anzio is on weapons tight, so she will not raise any weapons in her own defense. However, as we saw before, the decoys will fire in her own defense as they are designated point defense weapons, the decoys. As well, the close-in weapon system, the Phalanx, or Sea Whiz, will also fire in defense, and any other weapons that have a point defense designation. In addition, the evolved Sea Sparrow missiles are also designated point defense weapons and may fire in defense, regardless of weapons tight or weapons free. Now, we'll continue the scenario and watch as the weapon approaches. Notice how the Anzio maintains emissions control and stays silent. Here come some more missiles. These are Tomahawk missiles aimed towards the bunker complex behind the Anzio. The Anzio takes no action on her own, even though she knows that a missile is inbound and directed towards her. We'll see as the missile approaches the Anzio. And we'll pause at this moment. The Harpoon missile has conducted her attack. We will check the Anzio, and we can see that the Anzio has fired decoys in her own defense. See, there should be six, and chaff and flare has been deployed. As well, the Bushmaster has fired, and so has the Phalanx gun that is able to come to bear on the target. So, these are the point defense weapons as fired by the destroyer in her own defense. Now watch, we'll continue. Watch as the Tomahawk will fly near right over the ship. So easily it is in range of all the weapons. However, the Aegis cruiser takes no action towards it because she's on weapons tight. Her radar stays passive and her weapons do not engage. The missile flies over and proceeds onwards towards the target. Under weapons tight, the surface-to-air missiles batteries, land batteries, are also on weapons tight, so they are not firing either. And we will see as it approaches the bunker complex. And there's a hit. A second missile has been deployed, and we can see that it's another Tomahawk. At this point, we will go weapons free. Please note, it's still under unassigned or manual control. Notice the long-range weapons, the surface-to-air missile, the standard Block 3s, are engaging the enemy missile at long range. The emissions control has gone active by its own because we've gone weapons free and we've pretty much turned over the air defenses to the AI. And we've successfully destroyed the inbound Tomahawk. Once again, we're going to return to weapons tight and watch as the AI launches another missile towards the bunker complex. Here it comes. We'll let this one pass as well, noting that once again, even though we're active, we'll turn it off. We will go back to passive, and the AI will simply fly over us. Now we'll demonstrate what happens on a mission when the control is turned over to the AI. We will create a simple support mission, and we will leave it as passive. We will assign the Anzio to this support mission. So, the Anzio is going to sail back and forth between the reference points, and we'll continue. Now, we notice we are still on weapons tight, however, the AI has decided to fire her surface-to-surface missiles. Previously, even though on weapons free, the surface-to-surface missile did not fire on their own volition. Only when we turned the control over to the AI did the AI automatically engage the enemy ships. So, weapons tight is only applicable to air anti-air defenses. Now that we've turned over control to the AI has elected to go active and has fired her surface-to-surface missiles towards the enemy ships. As well, we can see that the AI has elected to engage the enemy Tomahawks, even though we are still on weapons tight. Therefore, once again, any AI side or any unit under AI control, that means under missions, an AI mission, we are granting authority we are turning control over to the AI to act as it please, and weapons tight or weapons free, the AI will decide what it wants to do and shoots down the missiles. This concludes the demonstration of how the weapons tight works in Harpoon 3, or should work in Harpoon 3. This is the last version that actually works, which is Harpoon 3.6. Next, we'll examine how the weapons tight does or does not work in the ANW and HUE versions of Harpoon. This demonstration is how the weapons tight command works under ANW or version 3.9.4 of Harpoon. We'll load the same demonstration scenario. And we will once again, we will show how the AI does not work, the weapons tight does not work. We are still in command of the CG Anzio, and we are on passive and unassigned. Therefore, we should be under manual control of the player. We'll make sure that our game preference, we have weapons tight. And we'll start the scenario. Once again, our radar picket ship, the Invincible, detects inbound enemy surface-to-surface missiles. We'll pause. We can see that by the speed, these are Tomahawk missiles, and by their speed, we know that this is a Harpoon missile. Please note that the emissions control has gone active. The AI has decided on its own that this may be a threat, or looks like a threat, but all missiles are automatically engaged. We can try to turn it off, and the AI will simply ignore us as we continue. We've totally, yep, there it goes again, active. So we, even though we may not wish to engage, we are forced to do so. The AI simply takes control and ignores any human contact and any human intervention. Remember, we're still on weapons tight. Now this, even though the missiles are not aimed at the ship, the AI is ordering the Anzio to defend the bunker. Now, some may think this is logical, but in many instances, this is a bad behavior. Mainly because we may not want to defend the bunker. There may be something else we wish to save our missiles for, and we are unable to do this. The bunker may already be destroyed, or it may be a ship that's already destroyed and the missiles are still heading towards it. We'd be wasting missiles, shooting down missiles that are worthless. As well, sometimes the missiles are heading in a different direction, maybe across our barrel. Now, we don't want to engage them because they're going to miss anyway. We know that. However, the AI doesn't, and they insist upon firing our valuable missiles against worthless targets. Also, we may wish to maintain emissions control by keeping our radar silent so the enemy does not counter-detect us. Again, the AI refuses to obey our orders and simply does as it please. Remember, this is only towards AI. This is only for air defenses. Notice that even though The AI is blasting away at the inbound enemy missiles. The harpoons are not being fired at the enemy ships. So, to restate, once again, weapons tight is only in relation to air-to-air or air defense weapons. However, our area surface weapons, here go our evolved Sea Sparrows, as well as others, are being fired against our wishes. And here go the longer range standard missiles. Once again, against our wishes, there's nothing we can do about it. Now, AGSI, the game developer, has said that this was a deliberate change, of course, and they're within their rights certainly to do so. However, it's a bad change, and the uproar raised among players is that it's simply a bad behavior, simply because the player is no longer really controlling his game. He's just moving units around until the AI decides to take over and starts firing things. Sometimes we're defending dead units, sometimes we're wasting missiles on missiles that are going to miss anyway. We can set no priorities. The AI simply reveals everything and acts as it likes. Now, certainly the AI is able to defend itself and the units around it. However, it was always able to do this in the first place. Remember, once a unit is on an AI mission, the AI takes over, and the AI sides and AI missions, AI is always on weapons free already. There is no need for this. The only thing that this new behavior kind of screws is the human player. A human player has no control over units, so what's the point of the human being in the game? He's simply there to turn it on, move a few units, and watch the AI blast away. Once again, we're going to create a small unit here, and we will create a support mission with weapons free, and we will assign the Anzio. Notice that the Anzio is now firing her harpoons. See, under manual control or unassigned and plotted mission, even though the weapons were taken by the AI, they were not fired against ships. Once we created a mission for the cruiser, the AI started blasting away at the enemy ship. This concludes our demonstration of how weapons tight works, or more importantly, doesn't work under Harpoon ANW version 3.9.4. This is a demonstration of how the weapons tight command functions under the Harpoon Ultimate Edition of the game, also known as HUE or version 3.10 of Harpoon. Once again, we will load the demonstration scenario and we're in command of the Aegis Cruiser Anzio once again. Under AGSI recognized its problem, amazingly. Under ANW, which had weapons tight, was totally ineffective. And AGSI has tried to accommodate and make changes. The changes they have put in is another level of control. Under the settings menu, it is called the Rules of Engagement. It's a little confusing, however, it says under the rules of engagement, human controlled units, meaning those under plotted or unassigned on the human side, human control, will automatically engage contacts when they are weapons free. This is the will resemble most closely resemble the original function under Harpoon 3.6. It's a wonder why they just didn't go back to the original. However, this is a facsimile of that behavior. Now, there's a second one under weapons tight. So, if this box were checked, then it is conceivable that the weapons would still fire even though the weapons are tight. They'll still fire in self-defense. Haven't checked this one out very much. Don't care very much for it. That's not the one. It pretty much sounds like what would happen under A&W, where AI would just take control of your units and just do whatever it pleased. So we're going to leave this one off, and we're going to leave this one free. So only under weapons free will the AI start to defend herself and area. We'll save that. Also under settings, we'll check the game preference, and we'll make sure that our weapons are tight. We're still in the same situation as before. We are in command of the Anzio. She's on passive and unassigned, and right now it's under manual control, manual human control. And we are so only the air defenses are affected. So we'll start the game. There's our previous invincible. She is once again providing us radar picket support. And here come the enemy missiles. As we can see, the number of them are headed towards the bunker. These are the Tomahawks once again. Please note that our ship is maintaining radar silence. So this is, it's acting very responsibly, very similar to the original Harpoon 3.6 weapons tight. As the missiles come in, they're well within range, and we maintain our emissions control. So control does appear to have returned to the player. So they fixed the problem, it appears, at least on the surface on the first glance. However, at second glance, there are other problems. Now, we know that the missiles are not being engaged, and they're well within range by our Anzio. And we'll even let the first ones fly right over, right past our point defenses. Okay, so they're right past our point defenses, and nothing has fired on them. Excellent. Now, we're going to go weapons free to demonstrate that control has returned, and the AI will start engaging. There we go. And firing missiles at all the potential targets. Anzio just opens up and has gone active on her own. And she's killing Tomahawks left, right, center at her leisure. Notice that the surface-to-air missile land batteries are also firing and engaging the targets. Now we notice that our standard missiles are engaging the second wave of Tomahawks. This is good. However, we're now going to create a simple mission as before. We're going to create an anti-surface warfare mission, patrol mission. And we'll have the radar. That's okay. Now, from this mission, we will assign the Anzio. So, in anti-ship patrol mode. In previous versions, in Harpoon 3.6 and even in Harpoon ANW, the Anzio would continue to engage, because once you're on an AI mission, the AI should be weapons free. And the last ones are brought down. Do notice that now that they're on AI mission, the weapons are not firing any longer. The missiles that are already airborne will continue. However, the Anzio has plenty of other surface-to-air missile, and it simply refuses to fire. This is under an AI control. Now, we're going to pause, and we'll change the rules of engagement, and we'll change everything to see if this makes any difference. And we can see that the AI refuses to engage any missiles. We'll change the setting again. Perhaps it's the wrong one. And still, we have no result. Once again, our weapons are free, and we will change the setting, rules of engagement, again. At this point, we've gone through all the various combinations and permutations allowed to us under the rules of engagement new menu. And we'll even try the focused strike option, just to see if we can get any of our surface-to-air missiles to defend them. Notice that under the AI, under 3.6 and ANW, the missiles would be engaged at this time. However, there is no way we can get the Anzio to operate her area defenses, and she's still got plenty. We'll confirm this by selecting our manual attack, and we could fire missiles if we wanted to, but we have to do this manually. It's an AI, and it's already on a mission, and it's refusing its orders to attack. Now, notice we are going to take just to prove our point, we will take the Anzio and we will turn off, we will take her back to unassigned manual mission, and we will see. Notice she is still not engaging any enemy contacts, any missile contacts. We'll pause and we will turn back the engagement so it's weapons free, so that she may engage the... There they go. And they're firing off at all the different missiles. Even the harpoons are inbound on the ship, and she's defending herself against them. But she's also defending herself all the area defenses. Now, the only time that it fires is when the ship is under human control. Under AI control, we cannot get the surface-to-air missiles to fire and defend the other targets. Therefore, in summary, Weapons Tight works under Harpoon 3.6. Weapons Tight does not work under Harpoon ANW. Weapons Tight kind of works under Harpoon HUE 3.10. It is not definitively proven, however, it does appear as though the developers were trying to fix the Weapons Tight command, and they did so for human control. Unfortunately, they managed to break every other mission within the game. So, by trying to fix a small thing, they broke the other 13 missions within the game. This concludes the demonstration on the current status of Weapons Tight. Works in H3, doesn't work in ANW, minimally works in HUE. This also demonstrates that even though AGSI and its fanboys can make claims, there is no guarantee that they are true.